and the senior Javonte Hawkins to jump. The ball controlled by Fordham. Anderson working off a screen. Ohawks.
VCU, of course, in their man-to-man defense. Get up tight as much as they can. Fordham's guards are taller, and that's a concern for VCU. There's a back cut, but Johnny Williams got his hand on the ball.
Williams playing tough defense. Shot clock down to three. Hawkins got a look, take a shot, steps back. A long three from distance, and he drains it.
That just kills you as a coach and as players. Play perfect defense for 29 seconds, and you end up with a three going in. They're going to take a look at it to see if it beat the shot clock. I think it did.
Hawkins just a 31% three-point shooter.
Now let's see here. We cannot see the clock, so we can't tell. It's at zero as the ball's in the air. But the question is, was it at zero before it came off his fingertips? And the other question is whether the officials can get a look at it, and looks like the basket is going to count.
A quick start here for Fordham, up 3-0.
I thought he had gotten it off. It was very close, but I thought he released it, and the clock hit zero while the ball was in the air.
Fordham averages 8 made three-pointers a game. That's third best in the A-10.
They shoot a lot of threes.
Here's Johnny Williams, the free throw line, driving baseline. Going to dribble out of the double team here, 18 on the shot clock.
And Fordham will double team every chance they get. That's why one of the reasons they get so many steals and turnovers. Very good defensive team.
Allie Cox, they work it around the perimeter. Lewis for three. Big offensive rebound by Burgess, and another look here for VCU.
New shot clock. And rebounding is a big concern for Jeff Neubauer tonight.
Williams trying to find Tillman.
Poor pass.
We go the other way. Tartuti thought about the three. Portable reset.
Good job by VCU converting on defense there. That's something they're going to have to do all night, as we mentioned earlier.
Ohams, 15 on the shot clock. Hands it off to Anderson.
Boy, that was a moving screen.
Chartuni off a screen for three. That's good. Back-to-back threes to start for Fordham.
As you mentioned, Fordham likes to shoot threes, but they only shoot about 31%. Tonight, they're 100% on their first two possessions.
Shooting the reigning A-10 Rookie of the Year. A quick start here for Fordham at home, up 6-0. Burgess loses the handle in a turnover.
And that's exactly what happened. That was an unforced error. Again, they do well getting back on defense.
Sangfelder fakes the dribble. Here's Chartuni. Ohams at the free throw line. He lost the handle. We go the other way. Lewis on the break, going all the way to the basket. Draws contact and lays it in for two.
And that's a good sign for Will Wade. He talked about the Davidson game. One of the big problems the Rams had was finishing around the basket. But Lewis with the steal and the finish.
Gordon breaking the trap. Hawkins along the baseline. Averaging just under 14 points per game.
I mentioned earlier that Jeff Neubauer recruited him twice. He transferred to Eastern Kentucky. There's another unforced error.
Lewis, throw the lob for Tillman. He can't get the flush to go down.
Nice idea, poor execution.
VCU going to the bench early. They're going to bring in Doug Brooks.
Will Wade will play 9 or 10 guys. By 10 minutes into the game, he'll probably have at least 9 guys on the floor. There you see the lob pass. It was just a little bit wide, and Tillman couldn't quite get close enough to the rim to finish. See you showing that pressure.
Anderson spinning away from traffic. Chartuni will hand it back, 20 on the shot clock as Fordham sets up their offense.
Best way to handle pressure usually is to attack it.
And there's a foul. It's going against Burgess for a hold.
Again, 2 years ago, that's not a foul. But the NCAA changed the rules. They want all those touch fouls called. And the officials know that, so they call them. My feeling, Tom, is you should call a foul if a player gains an advantage because of the contact.
Lob back door for Anderson, trying to keep it in. Sangfeld will fire three. That's no good. And the rebound to VCU.
Fordham's tried three shots, all of them threes. The other two possessions, turnovers.
Well, Tillman, the intended target that time, and another unforced turnover by BC. So both teams a little shaky here in the opening minutes of this game.
It's an old saying in sports, sometimes it's better to try easier. It looks like both teams, particularly VCU, trying too hard.
Both teams trying to bounce back after road losses.
Fordham doing a good job breaking the press. Clearly they practiced against it. You may see Will Wade back it off later in the game.
Anderson, Ohams. Alec Cox is going to get called for a push as he tried to fight through the screen that time.
When Alec Cox hits you, you stay hit.
Look, there's a lot of talk about him playing football.
Yeah,
he's
got a tight end's body. There's no question about it.
The trend we've kind of seen over the last 5 or 6 years, guys making the jump basketball to football in the NFL.
Well, it's been done. You go back to Cornell Green, the Hall of Fame defensive back for the Cowboys, was a basketball player in college, but no football. I don't know how I dragged that name out of my memory there.
That's a good one. And there's another three third of the game as Christian Sangfelder. He's put up 127 along the season, and that one goes down.
They still have not attempted a two.
Tillman wide open, can't get it to go.
And that's what Will Wade said earlier today. He said, we've got to make them take two.
Hawkins strong to the basket, lays it in for two more.
Now the good news for VCU is that they made him take a two.
11-2 Fordham. Brooks to the basket, draws contact.
Total force. He got bailed out there with a blocking call.
Fordham out to an early lead, 11-2 over VCU.
He thought that it should have been a charge. Alfred Smith had a block, and it was at the very least a questionable call. Let's put it that way. If it had gone the other way, I wouldn't have been surprised.
Played. Doug Brooks to the line, a 60% free throw shooter. Sixth leading scorer on the team.
By the way, not that unusual for the Rams to get off to slow starts. They were down 16-0 at home to Princeton back in November. Came back and ended up winning that game. So they're not likely to panic, as I mentioned, a very veteran team.
Brooks gets the pair to go. 11-4, Fordham on top.
Using Sengfelder as the outlet against that press to get the ball across midcourt.
Fordham 3 of 4 to start this game from three-point range. They shoot just 32% on the season.
And again, just the fact that they're shooting threes is not what Will Wade wants.
Hawkins, 5 on the shot clock. Dowdy covering Hawkins for 3. That one rattles around and Tillman up high to get it.
That was a tough shot. It almost went in. Hit the rim about 3 times. That's going to be a block, too. At least they're consistent. And I think that call by Wally Rutecki was probably right, and I'll tell you why, Tom. It looked like it took a little bit of a dive, a little bit of acting here. Watch this. Here's the contact. Oh! Nope. You don't get the foul call. You might get an Oscar. Or here in New York, a Tony.
Right. I think you were right with Sengfelder. He looked like he was in pretty good position on that other one.
He did. Now 3 seconds, which is called at least once a year by every official. They call
it.
The rules? They call it so that the supervisors know that they know it's still in the
check
rules.
It off the box.
That's the second 3-second call I've seen this season, and it's January 18th.
VCU trailing 11-4 early stages of this one. VCU's won 6 straight over Fordham, including 2 here at Rose Hill. Hawkins. Having just under 14 points per game, their leading scorer. Here's Anderson. Slonina. Chartuni had a pass deflected. It's loose.
Look out.
And it'll stay with Fordham. Good effort there by Brooks.
Hawkins was coming right at you, Tom, and you did not flinch.
I would have moved.
I've gone down more than once. The worst one was James Worthy.
Oh,
came over a press table to try to get a loose ball.
Let's see.
You see the scramble. Boy, it looked like it was last touch by Hawkins, didn't it? But they get the steal.
Another turnover. And here goes Lewis all the way to the basket. Leaves it for Brooks.
There's a foul before on the pass. So they'll inbound underneath.
Don, you talked about Jaquan Lewis in the pregame. He had 17 points last week against Davidson, but all in the second half. But really a key player for this VCU squad.
No, they need Jaquan Lewis to do Jaquan Lewis things, which is run the offense, hit threes, get to the basket, and set up the other guys. And he's had two steals here so far in the early going.
Dowdy off a screen. Brooks into the paint, hesitates, goes up off the glass. That's no good.
That was really good defense there. I thought Brooks made a good head fake, but still couldn't get open. The help was there.
It was a nice initial move, but then didn't get a good look at the basket. There's a whistle away from the ball.
I tell you, the dominant figure in this game so far has been Alfred Smith. He's made just about every call. Not the Alfred E. Smith who ran for president, just for the record. He was from New York.
Burgess will take a seat. Matt Homney going to check in. He had a nice game. His first double-double of the season last week against David. 13 points and 10 rebounds.
Homney's come a long way. You know, back in December, Will Wade sat him down for a couple games. He didn't like the way he was listening, concentrating, not playing particularly hard at times, and seems to have gotten a message.
Anderson for three.
Four threes in 6.5 minutes.
Fordham is 4 of 6.
They average, as you said, 8 a game. At this rate, they're going to end up with about 20.
Omdi with the left hand, that's no good.
Good defense there by Slanina.
Oham's ripping the rebound.
They missed him this past weekend in St. Bonaventure. He had a virus and couldn't play.
Anderson left wide open, couldn't hit the jumper. 14-4. Fordham on top. Lewis dribbling out of traffic.
They will double team when they get the chance.
Lewis into the paint. Brooks looking underneath. That pass is deflected. It's loose in the corner.
Another turnover. Has just come in and played excellent defense. Really good post defense. Denying the post and changing shots. Set a good hard screen there.
Lob for Sengfeldt in the corner. Ohams for three. That misses everything. Lewis downloaded Tillman on the block, spinning through traffic, loses the handle. It fell that time right to Dowdy. It was a fortunate break there for VCU. And then a foul committed.
Samir Dowdy's done a nice job off the bench as a freshman for Will Wade. Had to start one game because Johnny Williams turned up sick the morning of the game. But he's played extremely well off the bench. And there you see, he did get fouled.
Tillman, who had a career-high 27 points. The win last year for VCU with these two teams, Matt, also had 10 rebounds in that game.
Tillman is one of those guys who you look at, see that live body and the way he can move, you think he can go for 30 and 10.
He's Dowdy with it, averaging just over 8 points per game. On the block, looking underneath for Tillman. Ball takes a deflection, stays with VCU. 10 on the shot clock, Lewis the head fake. Dowdy for three. Got it.
Made me look good there, didn't he? Usually it goes the other way around. But nice look, nice inside-outside look there to find Dowdy on the perimeter wide open.
Just a 22% three-point shooter, but that was smooth. Chartuni to the glass, lost the handle.
That's a walk. Yep. Double dribble. Could have called it either one.
Fordham on top. 14-7 over VCU. The Rams coming back here in the Bronx. Tom Colbert, John Feinstein. Fordham on top early, 14-7. Tavares working on Dowdy at the free throw line. Off the glass, too strong. And the ball out of bounds. It'll stay with the Rams.
And they get a new 30-second clock because that shot did hit the rim.
To clarify, it'll stay with the Fordham Rams.
Yeah, it's going to stay with the Rams one way or the other. Actually, if you say stay with the Rams, we know it's staying down here with Fordham. Nice inbounds pass there.
Hawkins.
Allie Cox did a good job to get in position with another three.
Second three of the game for Sengfelder. He is their leading three-point shooter at over 37%. I got 48 on the season.
And they've now made 5 threes in just over 9 minutes.
Tillman just inside the free throw line. Can't get the runner to go. Allie Cox, a nice offensive rebound. Dowdy open for three. Got it. His second of the game.
Now, that was a heads-up play by Allie Cox, getting that rebound, realizing that the entire Fordham defense was inside the lane and finding the open guy at the three-point line. As you said, Dowdy, not necessarily a three-point shooter, but he's made two already tonight, both wide open.
He was just 8 of 37 coming into tonight's game. Zangfelder, Tavares. Hawkins fakes the jumper, now drives to the basket, and a nice lane for two.
That was either an NBA move or a Euro step. Take your choice.
Fordham on top, 19-10. Tillman open along the baseline, the reverse layup a little short, and Sengfelder up high for the rebound.
Oh, Wade is having visions of Davidson again because his team really hasn't finished around the basket. Give some credit, though. Fordham's defense has been very good. They're willing to give up the occasional three if they can guard the inside.
Fordham, not the biggest team, but they're athletic. They'll go get rebounds.
It's going to be a bump on the drive.
And right now, the biggest guy on the court right now is Sengfelder at 6'7 for this Fordham squad.
Yeah, but they're very active on defense. And when they make threes the way they've been making them, they're very hard to guard. Foul was on Jaquan Lewis trying to fight through a screen. One guy they can't afford to have getting foul trouble is Lewis, that's for sure.
Flanina on the right block. Going to go at Hondi, loses possession, ball to the floor, and gets it back.
It's amazing that wasn't a walk. And I think Wally Rutecki said, well, we didn't catch the walk, so we'll throw in 3 seconds. That might be an NCAA record in the last 50 years for three-second calls in a game, too. I've been watching basketball for 1,000 years. I can't remember the last time I saw 2 3-second calls in a game.
Here's Williams back in the game. Driving baseline, underneath traffic, kicks it out. Dowdy open. Can he make it three straight?
That was a tougher catch. He had to catch it and then get into shooting position rather than just catch and shoot. That's the catch and shoot.
That's short. Fordham continuing to fire from distance.
That's what they like to do.
Tenth of the game for three, and a nice move by Lewis.
Nice play by Jaquan Lewis, not just settling for the quick three, but using the shot fake to get himself into good shooting position.
Lewis averaged just over 15 points per game, 13th leading scorer in the Atlantic 10. And it's a 7-point game in the Bronx. Flanina. And a foul called against Hamdi.
Hamdi just reached in there trying to knock the ball loose. And knocked Flanina. Got the ball, but also got Slanina's arm.
Now, we mentioned his progression coming off that double-double. What have you liked about his game as we watch this nice jumper by Lewis?
Well, I think just that he's been more aggressive. Which is what Will Wade wanted out of him. You know, early in the season, he was starting. And Mo Alley Cox was coming in off the bench, and they were splitting time. But Alley Cox was playing so well, he had to get more minutes. And Hamdi sulked a little bit, didn't like it. And Will Wade said, well, we don't sulk around here. So he sat out a couple games and has come back with a much better attitude.
Anderson almost lost it in the air. Chartouni will take a three. That's no good.
Fordham wasn't going to hit at a 67% rate all night. And that's what Johnny Williams will do. If you don't turn your head on defense, he'll burn you.
Williams, the fourth leading scorer on the team. Shooting over 50% on the season.
And a lot of that is because he can get to the basket so well. Don't expect a 6'1 guard to be that effective in the lane, but he is.
Bertuti hands it off. Anderson pulls up. And the jumper is good.
That was a tough move by Anderson. Just did a great job of clearing space for himself.
Anderson, the third leading scorer. Fordham, just over 11 points per game. Williams. Hamdi, looking underneath.
Yeah, it was Hamdi forced the high-low there. They were lucky that wasn't a turnover.
Hamdi, take the off-bounce jumper, gets it to go. He hung up in the air.
He got a big grin on his face coming down court. Because that was good defense, and he literally went under the defender to get that shot off.
And he went just in the air and somehow got it to go. Yeah.
Kids practice those shots, you know, Tom.
Chartouni.
They really do.
Slanina left open on the wing for three, and that's good.
Yeah, you got to find shooters. Slonina can make that shot, as he's proven, and no Ram in black anywhere near him.
Slonina has international experience at the youth level of the Czech Republic. Nice move by Hadi all the way to the basket for two.
Good pass by Ali Cox. Good interior passing there. Defense leaned toward Ali Cox. He recognized it, found Hamdi, who had the opening and scored.
Seems like both teams settling down a little bit more, getting to a rhythm offensively.
They're not forcing things as much as they were the first few minutes.
Sartuni looking underneath, and that went through the legs of Slonina. Williams making a nice run to the basket. And VCU coming back here in the Bronx.
Who's a student coach now. He was a player, had some concussion issues. If the name sounds familiar, his grandfather is Rolly Massimino, who, of course, won the national championship at Villanova in 1985. He's still coaching. He's 82 years old. He's still coaching at Kaiser, what's now Kaiser University in Florida, an NAIA school. They're 15-5 this year. And Matt was telling me before the game that yesterday he was talking to his grandfather on the phone, and he mentioned that he'd gotten so mad he threw his team out of practice. At the age of 82, he's still throwing his team out of practice.
Well, that's one of the legendary names of all of basketball.
Should be in the Hall of Fame. 808 wins.
Another turnover, seventh of the game by VCU. Anderson can't get the finish, and we go the other way.
Well, Sengmelder almost brought him down. Bunting almost brought him down by accident. They nearly collided. I think that threw him off. Nice catch.
Tillman.
But he didn't finish. He caught, but he couldn't hold.
Eighth turnover of the game for VCU.
Now, I don't know if in the NFL that would be called a catch.
No, I don't know.
If he made a football move.
He's definitely not a football move either. John Fordham shooting 56% through the first half here. 9 of 16, 6 of 11 from downtown.
Yeah, that's their game. They've shot 11 threes and 5 twos. And Will Wade wants that number reversed.
Fordham on top, 24-18.
Fordham has done a good job moving the basketball to get those threes. And they're forced to take a timeout there. Good hands by Doug Brooks to almost create a turnover, but Fordham takes their use-it-or-lose-it timeout.
And we talked about it in the pregame. Both these teams like to pressure and force turnovers. And last year in the meeting between the two teams, Fordham had 18 turnovers. VCU scored 28 points off these turnovers.
Yeah, and that's the other thing. When you get hours from all
of there are a couple kids on that team that are local products from Rochester.
So good move.
Huge turnout.
Yeah.
Anderson almost lost the handle.
Oh, slippery to that.
Five on the shot clock. Anderson pulls up for three. Off the front of the rim, no good.
So first time the shot clock was way down and Fordham didn't score. That's something.
Contact with no ball. As they play on Lewis, spinning out of traffic.
See, I kind of like the fact that Brian O'Connell didn't call that because there was no advantage game. But that's not the way the game's being called, generally speaking. And a minute later, we have a foul called away from the ball.
Duar going to go back to the bench. In his second season.
Yeah, as you mentioned, 10 years at Eastern Kentucky. Won 20 games his last 3 years there. Went to the NCAA tournament. Coached under John Beilein. Played at LaSalle.
Had a good first season here. 17-14, the most wins for Fordham since the 2006 season. And their first postseason appearance since 1992, playing in the College Insiders Tournament.
He said, you know, you got to keep things in perspective. For us, last season was a home run. And that was a turnover. Players fall in love with that lob sometimes. That's
nice
a better pass. And that's, ooh,
that's
that looks like
block.
A foul. Wow. It's a great block by Obams.
Ohams up high to get that Ohams one. Hawkins to the lane, lays it in for two.
Boy, Ohams made that play by running back on defense. It looked like Hamdi had an easy dunk off that pass. And he blocked it from behind and ran the court. Set everything up.
Williams dribbling through traffic all the way to the basket. Comes up short.
They are letting them play. That's for sure. And the players have to adapt to that. They have to expect the contact. That's a walk.
Travel called on Chartuni. Rating A-10 rookie of the year.
It's weird, Tom, but the court seems a little slippery. The ball seems a little slippery. There's been a lot of slipping and sliding around here. And we're not in an arena where there's hockey ice under.
No bad weather outside here in the New York City area?
Weather's fair. I've certainly seen worse in New York in my lifetime. By the way, the last time I was in this gym for a game, I hate to admit it, was 1971. Digger Phelps was the coach. They were on their way to a 26-3 record. The NCAA Sweet 16 was his only year at Fordham. He went to Notre Dame the next year.
Dowdy to the basket. Hesitates. Can't get it to go. Tillman with the offensive rebound. Lewis for three. That's no good.
Nice rebound there.
Anderson pushing it ahead.
Anderson just took it. That was something Will Wade talked about, the fact that Fordham's guards are a little bit bigger than his guards. And that was a concern, throwing the ball over traps and also rebounds.
Tavares lost the handle.
Nice. That was Samir Dowdy from behind.
Lewis trying to leave it for Dowdy. Too much on the pass.
Going too fast.
And that brings us to a timeout. John Polk for John Feinstein. Fordham shooting 52% for the game. 6 of 11 from downtown VCU. Up to a little bit of a slower start, 7 of 18, but they played better, John, as the last 3 or 4 minutes of this game.
Well, the threes are the difference in the game. Everything else is even. They both take in 19 shots in all. They both have 11 rebounds. The turnover, sloppy game, 10 for VCU, 8 for Fordham. We talked about how the ball and the players' feet seem to be slipping and sliding, but 6 threes for Fordham, 2 for VCU. That's why Fordham's got the 8-point lead.
Tavares. Ohams, that big block. Anderson, 8 on the shot clock, got to go. On the wing, into the paint, all the way to the basket, as rejected by Williams. What a play by the guard.
Wow. That was a great one-on-one block, no help. Johnny Williams just getting in position and blocking that ball out of bounds.
He's listed at 6'1", but he went up high.
Maybe
to
it's
reject
the beard.
That.
Give some superpowers or something. Watch this play. He looked like he was beaten. Goes up and just extends that arm and blocks it cleanly. 30-second violation.
Good defense there by VCU.
That's twice that either a shot had to be forced on because of the clock or the violation. Because when Johnny Williams blocked the ball out of bounds, obviously the clock didn't reset.
Samir Dowdy right now leading VCU with 6 points. Hawkins has 9 for the Rams. Here's Williams with it. On the elbow. Williams double teamed in the corner. He puts it across court.
Those double teams. He didn't. He got trapped.
Chartouni read it. Hawkins all the way to the basket and flushes it for two.
Well, Lewis made a mistake there defensively. Went for the steal. Didn't get it. And that set up the dunk for Hawkins. Nobody underneath to help. Another deflection.
Chartouni almost had back-to-back takeaways that time.
The Rams, the VCU Rams, just not sharp offensively. A lot of passes deflected, a lot of passes thrown into traffic.
11 turnovers already for VCU. Still 2:20 to go.
And that's just a huge number.
Lewis looking around. Dowdy all the way to the basket, steps through traffic and lays it in for two. A nice move by Samir Dowdy.
Dowdy's really giving them an important boost off the bench, help keep them in here.
Leading DC with 8 points, including a pair of three-pointers. Slanina hands it back. Chartouni to the basket. Reverse layup is good. A nice move by the sophomore.
It was a nice move, but Dowdy allowed him to get inside of him defensively. You got to keep your man in front of you.
Lewis picks up the dribble.
Fordham really attacking in the lane. As soon as somebody goes in the lane, it feels like there's three guys waiting. Look at that.
Ellie Cox. Dowdy step back three. That's no good.
Shot clock was down under 5 seconds. That's why Dowdy felt like he had to take that shot.
Fordham with the lead up by 10, 30 to 20. Both these teams losing on the road over the weekend. Fordham against St. Bonaventure. VCU at Davidson. And there's a foul as Chartouni made a nice move to the basket again.
They've done a nice job of getting through VCU's defense to the basket. Whereas on the other hand, VCU has often run into 2 and 3 men when they've gone inside.
The sophomore steps to the line. Reigning A-10 Rookie of the Year. He set a Fordham freshman assist record last year, 161 assists. As that first free throw is good, and Johnny comes into the game second in the NCAA in steals, averaging over three per game.
Well, he's one of the guys like Jeff Neubauer, that Jeff Neubauer thinks is going to get this Fordham program going where he wants it to go. She said they were 17 and 14 last year. They had some preseason injuries that hurt them this year. And they're trying to get their act together now in league play. They had that win at Davidson. Lost, as you said, on the road to a good St. Bonaventure team. And looking good at home so far tonight against VCU.
You mentioned that record last year, 17 and 14. School record, 14 wins here at home.
They did play 19 home games. That didn't hurt.
Lewis in the corner. Brooks being hounded by Anderson. 15 on the shot clock. That pass over everyone's head, even Tillman. At 6'7", couldn't get that.
And Tillman jumps like he's 6'10", and he couldn't get close. And Ram's a little bit frustrated here, just trying too hard to make something happen. There are no 10-point plays in basketball.
Well, you mentioned that comeback against Princeton, down 16-0. And the crazy part about that game, they tied it up at halftime. They erased that 16-point deficit in about an 8-minute span.
The last 4 minutes of the first half were a disaster for Princeton, like the first 6 minutes were a disaster for VCU. It was still a close game. Princeton didn't fold.
You talk about that game for this Fordham team and that win at Davidson. They held Davidson scoreless for the first 8.5 minutes of that game. So yeah, they can play some tough defense.
And they stopped Jack Gibbs, which is the key. If you stop Jack Gibbs at Davidson, you can win that game. Aldridge, a very good player, too, had a big game against VCU. But Jack Gibbs makes Bobby McKillop's team go.
15 on the shot clock. Hawkins looking to drive. Anderson will reset with 10. Anderson kicks it out. Sengfelder with 4, loses the handle.
No need to rush. They can wait for the last shot.
Now a chance here for VCU.
I'd pull it back.
Lewis kicks it out. Brooks for 3. That's no good off the side of the rim.
See, you got to have clock awareness there. I know they're trailing and they want to make stuff happen, but they should have kicked it back and held for the last shot of the half. Now Fordham gets the last shot. Maybe not.
Or do they? Allie Cox ahead to Brooks.
Can't get it off.
Band's making a trip up to the Bronx for this one.
The Rams travel. Often the band travels with them. Not tonight. The Peppers are back home. VCU could use them. One thing worth noting, Samir Dowdy inbounding in front of us for VCU starting the second half in place of Justin Tillman. Tillman really struggled in the first half. Had 4 turnovers among the 12 that VCU committed.
Dowdy from the corner. That's no good. Other ran the first half with 8 points.
Will Wade will look at that and say, we got a good shot on that possession.
Anderson for 3. That's no good. Fordham picks up right where they left off. Firing from long distance, then a foul away from the ball.
I was looking at my notes during halftime in my conversation today with Will Wade. And here are the points of emphasis he made. We got to make them shoot 2s. Well, they've shot 12 threes. We've got to finish around the basket. They haven't finished. We've got to not turn the ball over. They've turned the ball over. That's why they're down 12. Biggest deficit of the season at halftime. And there's another ball that just goes right through Jaquan Lewis's hands.
We mentioned in the first half they were down 16 to Princeton, but erased that to go into the locker room even at halftime.
Yeah, I think this is about the shot clock. It was at 29, and it wasn't supposed to reset. They reset it, and now they're putting it at 16. That was good. Wally Rutenko got that done quickly. Usually, when they have to do something
over
the shot clock, it'll take hours.
Look at some replays.
And they'll say, okay, we'll change it by 2 seconds. Time you got a 13-second change with no problem.
It's not like the NBA where you have to go back to Secaucus. It's worked around the perimeter. Ohams for 3. In and out, no good.
I guess the good news is we're not far from Secaucus.
Not far from where you grew up?
No, I grew up on the west side of Manhattan. I got to tell you, that Fordham team in 71 when they went 26-3, they took the city by storm. They played 2 games in Madison Square Garden, sold them both out, beat Notre Dame in 1, and lost to Marquette, which was ranked 2 in the country, by 5 in the other. I once said to Digger Phelps, you know, Digger, you were truly a great basketball coach. He went, oh, well, thank you. I said, at Fordham. He knew I was joking. Charlie Yelverton, Ken Charles, Ken Crucius. Vivid memories of that team.
Anderson. Here's Hawkins,
that's
left
a
open.
Deep three.
That's in and out, no good. 15th three-pointer of the night. Attempted by Fordham.
Well, they missed a few now, though.
Here's a three in the corner. Burgess got it.
And that's a big basket because both teams were a little cool coming out. Fordham could have made the lead 14 or 15. Instead, it goes to 9 as Burgess hits that three.
Burgess, a 35% three-point shooter. Gets that one to go, and Dowdy almost got the turnover.
And he was wide open when he made that three. And you can see, you mentioned the VCU fans, a little bit of life over there behind the VCU bench.
Ohams in the corner. Chartouni dumps underneath. Sankfelder left open and lays it in for a wide open two.
I am not sure what happened there, but there was a mix-up on defense. And the only guy anywhere near Sankfelder was Dowdy.
34-23 our score. And that pass had too much heat on it from Williams. Another unforced turnover by VCU.
Still going too fast. Williams had the right idea getting underneath and trying to get the ball to Burgess, but as you said, he threw a 100-mile-an-hour fastball, which is good baseball. Three guys went in the Hall of Fame today, but not so much in basketball.
Yeah, you like that initial step he made, but that's a little too high. Hawkins fakes the three. He's wide open. Now he'll take it and bury it.
That's
Alec Cox never
fault.
Came out.
Yeah, but you know what? That was a deep three, and Mo Alley Cox was willing to give it to him, and he drained it.
An offensive foul. That's going to go against Dowdy.
Ryan O'Connell thought Dowdy was a little out of control. See if we get it on replay. Here he comes. Yeah, it looked like he had position. I think that's a good call. Owens doing a nice job defensively. Got there before Dowdy did. Notice Will Wade didn't say a word.
There's a turnover. Williams draws contact, score the basket, and a foul.
Well, I said Will Wade was going to back off the press. That's why he's coaching, and I'm not.
You're over here with me.
Exactly. They put some press on. They desperately needed a turnover and an easy basket, and they get the turnover. Johnny Williams gets the bucket and the foul. That's a big turnaround.
VCU averages just under 9 turnovers. It forces 9 turnovers per game.
Force 12 in this game, but that's only the third time that they've converted it into a basket.
Gets the free throw to go. Williams is a 64% free throw shooter. See, Doug Brooks going to check back in.
Interesting. Williams makes a play and then comes right out.
Pressure by VCU.
And Fordham has handled the press most of the night until that last possession very well, bringing Sengfelder up toward midcourt to catch that pass to get it across the timeline.
VCU trying to erase that 12-point halftime deficit. The lob back door that time intended for Hawkins. Took a deflection.
That time, Mo Alley Cox was in position, that's for sure.
Well, it's the third lob attempt we've seen here tonight, and still 0 for 3 in terms of converting by both teams.
And you see again, Mo Alley Cox getting in the way. That's a tough shot.
The putback is good.
Oh, it has been the secret weapon here. Just a freshman tonight.
He's a local product out of the Bronx.
For Jeff Neubauer.
He got the start at St. Bonaventure as Burgess tries to dribble through traffic.
And got the start tonight, too. And he's played particularly well on the defensive end, but there he went between two VCU players to get that offensive rebound and stick back.
Just his second start of the season. Had 4 points in the loss against St. Bonaventure over the weekend.
Well, I would venture to say, given that he's a freshman, that this is the best game he's played in college to date.
Lewis off a screen for 3. That's no good. Ball takes a deflection. 2 Fordham players collided with each other. Stays with VCU, but a travel can be called on Brooks.
It's a good call. And Doug Brooks didn't play very much in the first half, about 10 minutes. And he and Tillman have really struggled so far tonight. Combined 0 for 6 now with 5 turnovers. That's not the kind of production Will Wade expects out of those two guys.
Fordham on top, 39-26. Chartouni, nice job to dribble away from traffic. All the way to the basket, kicks it in the corner. Sankfelder for 3. in and out. Allie Cox, great position, but nobody went for the ball.
He got help. That's why he's so frustrated. And now I think it's going to stay Fordham's way. Jeff Neubauer is ripping his jacket off. He needs to stay under control.
We'll stay with Fordham.
We'll see. Neubauer thought the call was going to go originally. I think Wally Rutecki was going to give it to VCU. Brian O'Connell came in and said, no, I got a better angle. Gave it to Fordham, but Neubauer was about to go nuts over there.
Tartuni gets it into Hawkins. He's trapped in the corner. And he stepped out of bounds. Good pressure by VCU defensively to force that turnover.
Let's see if VCU can convert here. They've actually 12-point lead's become a 13-point lead. The Rams need to get going. The VCU Rams. Fordham Rams are doing fine.
They have the lead. 39-26. Here's Williams dribbling through traffic. Leaves underneath Lewis in the corner. Brooks for three. Got it.
Big
second three for
there.
Brooks. Back to a 10-point game.
And Brooks has given him a boost here in the second half. Those two threes.
Langfelder trying to dribble through traffic.
You know, when you're trapping like that, you've got to play with your feet, not your hands.
He's used cut the deficit to 10. Fordham on top at home. Authorized by the Atlantic 10 Conference. Any rebroadcast, retransmission, or other use of any image, sound, account, description of this game without the express written consent of the Atlantic 10 Conference is strictly prohibited. Welcome back, everybody. Talk Ultra John Feinstein. VCU finding some rhythm down by 10 here with 15:40 left to go in the second half.
Yeah, well, Doug Brooks finally got off the schneid, hitting that three off out of the corner. And, of course, Jordan Burgess had the one early, and that's helped a lot. We've got to keep playing aggressive defense, and that's turned his, I'm not going to say it's turned his game around, but it's turned it at least in the right direction as far as VCU is concerned.
Dankfelder, lucky to get out of that one. And here's a little regroup with 10 on the shot clock. Working against Lewis. Down to five. Chartouni slips by one defender. Goes far to the basket. Has it rejected. Brooks ahead. Lewis the other way. Throws the lob for Tillman with a big flush.
That one works. And when it works, it's pretty to watch. And Tillman was wide open and the pass was perfect. And as I said, he jumps like he's about 6'10 anyway.
It's an 8-point game and a VCU chant here at Rose Hill Gym.
This crowd is close to half VCU in this place. Only seats about 3,500.
Singfelder, 8 on the shot clock. Chartouni into the paint. Cross-court pass. Hawkins, double team.
You're not going to get a shot.
Anderson has to put up with one. Got it!
Oh, my. Oh, my. That's about the fourth time tonight that Fordham's done it, and they've all been threes. I did not think he was going to get that off, but he did.
Anderson hits it at a 34% clip. Got that one to go with one on the shot clock.
Less than one.
Allie Cox, double team along the baseline, looking for help.
He stepped on the trap. Again, Fordham's interior defense tonight has just been outstanding. When they get in their half-court defensive sets, VCU has really struggled. Most of their offense has come out of transition. Here you see what a block shot can do for you. Mo Alley Cox with the block. Here comes the pass. Jaquan Lewis with the line. And the finish. Anderson with a little Harlem Globetrotters move. Boy, that's got to be a foul. Brooks was doing everything but dancing with him. I think they called it on Lewis, though.
Lewis obviously does not like that call.
Well, there was a foul. Doug Brooks had his arms wrapped around him, around Anderson. Lewis came in to try to double team, and they called the foul on Lewis.
42-31, Fordham on top. ECU trailed by 12 to start the second half, largest deficit of the season. Trying to bounce back for the loss of Davidson on their own. There's a whistle. The VCU Giants had so much success, but road games in the A-10 are not easy no matter where you go, no matter what the opponent's record is.
Yeah, you're 100% right about that, and that's why, you know, when you get a win on the road, it's such a big deal. I heard a stat the other day that when Notre Dame won over the weekend at Virginia Tech. It was the eighth win for a road team in the ACC and the third by Notre Dame. So the rest of the league, 14 other teams, five wins on the road combined. The A-10 is very similar.
Here's Anderson, third leading scorer on the team. I mean, just over 11 points per game. Segfelder for three from the wing. That's too strong. I think Hawkins can get called for a push as Tillman had position underneath.
He did, and you could see him kind of lurch backwards as he got pushed, and that's why the foul call came.
Of course, a lot of A-10 basketball played here in the New York City area with a tournament at Barclays Center.
Of course, it'll be in Pittsburgh this year. I can't keep track of the arena names up there.
Lewis looking for Tillman underneath.
Again, interior defense by Fordham leading to another turnover. Those empty trips are just killing VCU.
Segfelder thought about the three. Work to the top. Anderson, Hawkins in the corner. They swing it around the perimeter. Tartuni will reset with 10. Tartuni driving to the basket on the elbow. Cross-court pass to the bench.
Yeah.
The first
a lot
row
of wide open fans over there.
How about VCU coming to Atlantic 10 in 2012? They made it to the A-10 final every year. They won it at Barclays Center in 2015 over Dayton, winning 64% of their conference games since 2012.
Well, they've just been an excellent basketball program for a long time now. It's not like they all of a sudden got good when they went to the Final Four in 2011 under Shaka Smart. They were good under Anthony Grant. They were good under Jeff Capel. You could go all the way back to J.D. Barnett in the 1970s and 80s. This has been a solid basketball program for a long, long time.
Lewis splits a couple defenders. Nice lap for Tillman
that
in the big dunk.
Was the kind of interior passing you want. Lewis getting in the lane, squaring up, finding the open man, and then fouling in the backcourt. And that's not a foul that you want if you're Will Wade.
Especially 75 feet from the other basket.
And it's also three fouls on Jaquan Lewis. It's a really pretty pass. Defense was behind him. High percentage shot. And then on the inbounds pass, trying to press, Lewis commits a foul, and now he's going to come out at least for a little while.
You mentioned Tillman, that high percentage shot, shooting 58% from the field as the third best shooting percentage in the conference.
He takes a lot of high percentage shots. There's another turnover.
Two on one, but a whistle before Burgess can get going.
Yeah, it's probably a smart foul because it would have been a two-on-one.
You think both these teams would react okay to pressure because they like to apply it so much. You know, it's like in football when you have
practice.
Two option teams go against each other. You think they'd be used to defending that, but still, we have a lot of turnovers here tonight.
It is surprising, though. And we've seen a lot of plays where there's been a slippery ball or guys slipping down the court.
17 turnovers for VCU, 15 for Fordham.
That's a week's worth. Fouls starting to pile up here now. Six for VCU, four for Fordham. Isn't it amazing how many times you see a game, Tom, where the first half goes along nice and quickly, nobody gets in the bonus. Then the officials go in the locker room, they look at the stats, and they go, we haven't scored very many fouls. We better pick it up here.
We did call 2 3-second violations.
They were way ahead of the curve on the 3-second violation.
Burgess left open. Plays it into the corner. Grofield for three, and that's good. Lee Grofield, 37% from downtown, gets that one to go from the corner.
Grofield just came into the game for Jaquan Lewis. They find him in that corner. That's three threes by three players for VCU.
Segfelder has that one blocked.
And Brooks got over there to block that shot out of bounds.
Fordham on top, 42-36, but some big finishes by Tillman in the Bronx.
To get this game close, 42-36, the lead was 13 for a while, and they've made a couple threes, three of them actually, and picked up their defense to cut this margin, and now things get a little bit tense for Fordham.
10 on the shot clock for Anderson. Under pressure from Brooks.
We see you in a 2-1-2 zone.
Anderson, off the glass, no good. Ball's loose, and Williams comes away with it. Williams going coast to coast.
They forced it there. There was no need to go in one on three there. He had trailers. You can see Will Wade saying, Johnny had a chance to cut it to four there and just tried to do it all by himself.
Chartouni off the glass, score the basket and a foul for the sophomore.
A big bucket and a tough play. You mentioned he was the rookie of the year last year. He is a tough player. That was a nice move. Watch him. He looks like he might be a little out of control, but the help comes late, and he converts. And the reason that's not an offensive foul is because Burgess stepped into him to create the contact. You have to be waiting to create the contact to get an offensive foul call.
Chartouni, one of three players on this Fordham team fighting the flu. In fact, he was questionable last game against St. Bonaventure, played but didn't have any points. It's 0-4 from the field. And he gets the free throw to go.
And in that same game, Slanina didn't play at all. And he's played limited minutes tonight here. Apparently, there was a virus that went through the women's team here at Fordham. And the men started to get it last week.
How are you feeling?
So far, so good.
All right. Keep us posted.
Got a long trip home, though, don't I?
Williams. Being guarded by Hopkins. And well, Tillman with another huge throwdown, his third jam of the game.
Well, another high percentage shot.
Well, you can see why he's third in the conference in field goal percentage. Williams almost forces the turnover.
Boy,
the ball's loose, and he does.
Contact.
Williams gets it. Draws contact.
Yeah, he got fouled there, no doubt. Again, the defense has been doing a nice job for VCU, getting them opportunities here to close this gap. See, Williams catches it. There's the foul right across the arm. And he goes down hard, and our cameraman does a great job of not getting kicked in the gap.
Good news for VCU. Done right now, they're down seven, and their three leading scorers, Jaquan Lewis, Justin Tillman, and Johnny Williams, are combined at 6 of 15 from the field. Just 13 points.
Mm-hmm. What you wonder about is, will they shake that in time to come back and win this game?
It was last week where Lewis had 17 points in the second half against Davidson. They almost pulled out that comeback.
Well, the advantage you have when you're a team like VCU that has the kind of pedigree that we're talking about and the kind of experience is you're not going to panic in a situation like this. You know there's plenty of time left to still win the game. Whereas if you're Fordham, and you're trying to move up the ladder in this conference and prove yourself, and you know what a big win this would be, you got to kind of stay calm as VCU makes their move. They did a nice job breaking the pressure there as Lanina's back in the game.
Fordham still looking for their first ever win against VCU. VCU 6-0 all time, including two wins here. Chartouni pulls up for three. That's no good. And Williams with the rebound.
That wasn't a bad shot, just didn't go in. They've hit lower percentage shots than that tonight. Nice pass.
Tillman underneath got caught in the air.
Yeah, that's a jump ball, I think, yeah.
Nice play by Anderson to get a piece of that as Tillman was going up for another big finish.
He did a good job putting his hand right on the ball and not fouling. VCU will retain possession as the arrow will change with 22 seconds still on the shot clock, so plenty of time. I like that rule change. They used to recycle the shot clock back to 30 in this circumstance, but they figure if the defense makes a play, why penalize
it? Yeah, give them credit. Lewis off a screen, trying to leave it underneath for Ali Cox. That read by Chartouni. And another jump ball,
and this time it'll go Fordham's way.
John, Fordham started out 4 of 6 from three-point range, and now 6 of 12 for the game.
Well, they started out 4 of 6, and two of those four were made with the shot clock at one. So they have cooled off here in the second half, but they're still shooting 40% for the game from three. The goal is to shoot at least 33%, because if you shoot 33% from three, it's like shooting 50% from two.
Well, on the season, you see 35%, as you see Torrey Burson checking into the game for the first time.
That's 35% is solid. Fordham a little bit under that at 31, and that's not a good, particularly good stat because they take so many of them. And tonight, they've been solid. As you said, they started out really hot. They've only hit four of their last 14. So they've certainly slowed down, but they still have this six-point lead.
It looks like...
I don't know what the delay... Oh, there was some blood. Chartouni had blood and had to get it wrapped.
Looks like he's good to go.
Once upon a time, of course, you had to come out of the game. Now, if you can get it wrapped quickly, they let you stay in.
This past Monday marked the 92nd anniversary of this gym. January 16th, 1925, the first ever game, Fordham and Boston College. Fordham won that game 46-16.
I believe this is the second oldest on-campus gym in the country behind Boston University. Yeah.
Fordham just one of 14 Division I programs to have over 600 wins in their home gym.
Do you know who leads, who the all-time leader is?
Out on the West Coast, correct?
Yeah.
University of Washington.
At Edmondson Pavilion.
People might assume Duke or Kansas, one of those.
Duke's up there. I think Duke's third. Penn is up high on the list in the Palestra.
Erston. There's Brooks. Dribbling through traffic. 13 on the shot clock. In the corner. Grofield for another three. That's good. He's 2 for 2 from downtown.
He giving them a boost. He did not play in the first half.
He was 9 of 24 coming into the game from three-point range. He's at two big ones here tonight.
Giving him some space, and he's taking advantage.
Three-point game. VCU trailed by 12 at the half, their largest deficit of the season.
And VCU playing that 2-3 zone now, occasionally trapping out of it.
Chartuni thought about the three. Brofield got out there to cover. The float in the lane, no good by Tavares. We go the other way.
Bursted with a rebound, just came in. He's a walk-on. Doesn't usually play, except in situations where the game's over. But Will Wade, looking for some energy, brings him in on defense. And he grabs a rebound and gets fouled. It's only the sixth foul on Fordham, so VCU will not shoot. I think that's the sixth foul on Fordham, yeah. Bursted comes out after 1 minute and gets a huge ovation from the VCU fans.
Let's see you behind the bench. Three-point game. VCU can cut it to one or tie. Williams looking to drive. Down low, Tillman from 10. A little strong. Tip back's no good.
Might be outside his range. He's very good on dunks. Wasn't a bad shot, just didn't go in. Fordham looks a little bit out of sorts here at the moment.
What a finish. I thought there was no way Hawkins was going to be able to get to that ball when it went up.
When that ball went in the air, I said, well, that's a turnover.
I thought it was going to go off the shot clock.
And that was almost Grant Hill-like, 1991 Final Four National Championship game, when he reached into the third row for a Bobby Hurley passing dunk kick.
Hawkins through the paint. Crowfield again from the corner. In and out. It was halfway down.
It really was. That was a big play on that lob because it really looked like a turnover. And VCU was going to come down with another chance to cut it to one or tie. Instead, it's now five.
Hawkins fakes the jumper. And a foul called on the floor.
That'll be 1-1 when we come back.
ECU trailed by 12. They're down by 5 late here in the second half. Big finish that time from Hawkins. Off the bench, hitting a couple threes.
Yeah, a couple big threes. First one was when he came in for Jaquan Lewis after Lewis picked up his third foul and hit that first one out of the corner right away. And the three-point shot has been so big in this game. In the first half, Fordham was 6 out of 11, had a 12-point lead. This half, they're 2 out of 11, whereas VCU was 2 out of 6 in the first half. They're 4 out of 7 in this half and have cut the gap to 5. Hawkins 1-1, the first of 3. Fordham, pretty good free throw shooting team, a little over 73% for the season. And
Hawkins,
I jinxed him.
He's 83% himself on the season.
Yeah.
Nice work.
That's who you would have wanted up there if you're Fordham.
Dowdy dribbling through traffic. It was underneath to Tillman, and that time he finishes.
That was inside his range, too, a foot. But he's done a great job getting open on the inside for those shots that he's made. Really giving them a nice inside boost. They had none of that in the first half.
Three-point game again.
The zone's been very effective for the Rams.
Hawkins left open to the top of the key. That's way short. The ball's loose, and it stays.
Almost looked like the ball slipped off his hand a little bit, that he shot it off the palm instead of off his fingers that time, because he's too good a shooter to miss by that much.
Tillman and Dowdy now leading the way for VCU, 8 points apiece.
Either Jeff Neubauer or Will Wade will need their sport coach the rest of the night.
Hawkins leading the way for Fordham, 16 points. He'll take the long jumper from the top of the key. That's no good. Second time he's left alone. Couldn't get either one to go.
That one just flat out missed. Wide open, like you said. Chance again to tie with a three.
Tillman on the right block. Williams along the baseline looking for Tillman, but he stepped down. VCU.
Johnny Williams' fifth turnover tonight. That's just not like him.
And the 19th of the game for VCU.
And that's just not like the VCU Rams. I have to keep saying VCU Rams, Fordham Rams. I did a game the other day between UMBC, the Retrievers, and Albany, the Great Danes, and I said,
nice.
This game will go to the dogs. I'm sure about that. That's why I make the small bucks.
Oh, man. Oh, the glass.
I don't think he called it, but it counts.
Absolutely.
And a quick timeout by Jeff Neubauer.
Fordham on top, 49-44. VCU trying to make a late second half comeback.
Faithful friend.
5-point game as Tillman goes up strong. His fourth big flush.
And they just can't guard him inside when he catches the ball. You almost have to front him and deny him the ball and take your chances.
Hawkins the other way, looking around, leaves it. Ohams can't find anybody. Backdoor cut and a nice reverse layup by Sankfelder.
Jaquan Lewis got caught in a mismatch. Sankfelder went right by him, made that reverse layup.
Lewis cutting, leaving underneath. Well, he talks one up strong. He'll go to the line for two.
He's been very quiet tonight.
I was going to say, John, you look at the points. 23 points for the starters and 23 points off the bench. So how big is the bench?
Well, the bench is the reason they're in the game, particularly the freshmen who come in off the bench, hit big shots and provided points that they don't normally provide. Both Dowdy and Crowfield.
Ellie Cox, a 79% free throw shooter, knocks that one down, coming off 11 points and three blocks.
And Dowdy's got 8 points. Crowfield's got six. They desperately needed that. They could have used that free throw, too. But Mo Alley Cox has been very quiet all night. That was his first point of the night. A lot of people thought he'd have a big night. You mentioned Fordham's lack of size, but they've done a great job collapsing on him most of the night.
Been in double figures 8 times this season.
Back to man-to-man here for VCU.
Fortuny looking to work against Williams to the basket, off the glass, too strong. Good job to hang in the air, couldn't get it to finish.
Good defense by Johnny Williams.
Lewis for Tillman, went off the front of the rim.
Yeah, that's a missed shot in the stat books. Lewis very frustrated because Tillman was open, and he just didn't get the pass there. Got too close to the rim.
Anderson falls. Fortuny fakes the three, loses the handle, kicks it out. Anderson for three. Off the front of the rim.
Oh, he's hurt.
Out of bounds. It'll stay with Fordham. Good hustle by Sankfelder and Hawkins.
Yeah, Hawkins came down hard. I thought he was hurt there. But he gets right up, although he's going to the bench. He's kind of holding his wrist. No, he's not going to the bench. He's going to the corner. Yes, that's Ohams. Excuse me. Apparently he's okay. Tough kid. Ohams. Boy, he gets up. Kept that rebound alive, and Fordham gets the ball with a new 30. Fordham struggling with their shooting, though, from outside. As you mentioned, four of their first six threes, four out of their last 16 threes. Live by the three, die by the three.
Gave them that big first half lead. They were up by 12 at the break. VCU trying to come back from their largest deficit of the season. Chartuni to the basket. There's a big block by Mo Alley Cox.
Excellent block by Mo Alley Cox, catching it on the way up. And you are allowed in college to pin it against the backboard.
Well, stay with BCU. He leads the conference in blocks, 38 on the season. 4-point game. Fordham up, 51-47. It's a cut into the lead a little more here as we have under. after four to play.
Big possession here coming out of the timeout for VCU. They've gotten it to within three, within four, but they haven't been able to get a tie yet.
Williams.
Fordham back in the 2-3 zone. Very active zone.
Brooks for three. Got it.
And I was about to say, they don't play zone that much, and they didn't get to a shooter there, and now the margin's just one.
It's his second three of the night. 1-point game. Anderson looking underneath for the lob. Wide open. Hawkins underneath for two.
Again, VCU's inside defense just wasn't there. Hawkins made a very smart play, not trying to dunk the ball. He recognized he was under the rim, so he just caught it and laid it up.
Tillman, way too strong.
Yeah, that was a six-footer from 4 feet.
Chartuni to the basket, rejected by Tillman. It'll stay with Fordham.
Tillman has played a tremendous second half for VCU.
Under three to go. 3-point game.
You need to run your offense if you're Fordham at this point. You can't try to kill clock with 2:35 still left and a margin only three. Again, the clock's down to five.
hawkins leads into
to get a foul.
Contact. No call. Salinas put back his block.
30 seconds. 30 seconds. That was great defense by VCU. Got the block on Hawkins. The ball went right to Slanina, and his shot got blocked, so they never touched the rim. 30-second violation. Excellent defense by the Rams.
Same
the visiting Rams.
Yep.
And once again, this is probably the fourth time VCU's had the ball down three.
Got it within one. Williams to the basket, looking underneath for Tillman. He's triple team. Ball out of bounds. It'll stay with VCU, 19 on the shot clock.
Knocked out of his hands in there. As you said, he was triple teamed. And he knew it. He was trying to find the open man in the corner because the Rams have done such a good job finding shooters in that left corner in the second half.
Lewis.
Plenty of time on the shot clock.
Williams lost it.
Lost it again. That's his sixth turnover. Well, wait a minute. Now they're going to say it was deflected. No, they're not. I thought they were for a second.
20th turnover of the game for VCU tonight.
You win a game with 20 turnovers, you have to have done a lot of other things right. The best thing they've done in the second half is turn up their defense and make all those threes.
Under two to go. Fordham looking for their second conference win. VCU looking for their fifth. Hawkins has it poked away, gets it back.
I thought it was hit. Now we are under 2 minutes. So on a possession play, out of bounds, you can go to replay, but you can't go to replay here. Brian O'Connell's looking at me and says it was off his knee. And as a result, it's a backcourt violation.
VCU will get the ball back, down three.
And Will Wade takes a timeout here, first one he's taken in this half, so just to be in a Seagull fan.
1:45 to go, 3-point game.
If nothing else, they'll have the Peppers backing them up.
VCU trailed by 12, they cut it as far as one. Williams off the screen, pulls up from the free throw line, too strong. That ball saved in, and then a foul committed away from the ball against Sengfeld.
And that'll be 1-1. They'll shoot that. Or did they just... Yeah, they did call a foul. Wally Rutecki had the foul on Sengfelder. They're scrambling for a loose ball. He got possession and then committed the foul, so they won't shoot. Let's watch it here. They saved the ball in bounds, and there you see it. That's a good call. Sengfelder went right into... Was that Mo Alley-Cox? And down he went. And good play by Mo Alley-Cox, because I don't think anybody can really knock him down.
Tillman underneath, double team. Takes it back out. Williams.
Good recognition by Tillman that he was double teamed.
Lewis. Brooks for the tie. Got it!
Doug Brooks has really given them a boost with his three-point shooting. That's a 7-3 for VCU in this half.
The 30% three-point shooter. He's at three tonight. Chartuni
wow.
answers.
Wow, was that clutch? tied and you drain that three. They haven't made hardly any in this second half. That was only their third three of the second half. The first two were early.
Lewis has it rejected by Sengel, who will stay with VCU. 17 on the shot clock.
I would think Will Wade would want a timeout here. Down three. You want to make sure you get a good shot here. You don't have to take a three, Tom, in this situation, but you better take a good shot, because with 44 seconds left, if you don't score here, you're probably going to have to foul when Fordham, if and when Fordham gets the ball.
Last week at Davidson, BC made a late comeback. Lewis had a chance to tie the game on a three. The wing didn't go.
Well, this time they got the game tied. And then you've got to give all sorts of credit to Chartouni for just draining that three. Calmly. There's Brooks tying it. Here's Chartouni. Nice ball movement. They reversed the ball very well against the traps. Look at him. Wide open. And he didn't hesitate. So now VCU, they need to get a good shot. It doesn't matter if it's a two or a three. If they get it in the lane to either Allie Cox or Tillman, great. But if they get it in the lane and kick it to Brooks, who's been so hot, or Lewis, that's fine too.
It's in the corner. Lewis fakes the three, dumps it down low to Tillman. Goes up, scores the basket, and a foul.
Best of all worlds for VCU. They get it inside. Tillman gets a high percentage shot.
It looked like he juggled it on the layup, but managed to stay with it.
Got fouled and still finished. Again, we talked right at the start of the game about the importance of finishing for VCU, that they failed to do that in the Davidson game. Here you see, nice look on the pass. He certainly got fouled with the body, and he was able to finish. Now he's got to make the free throw to tie it.
Just a 60% free throw shooter.
Remember, though, 41 seconds left. And he swishes it. Now, if you're Fordham, do you call timeout or do you just run offense? They've got two timeouts left.
And they got a great look for Chartouni last time down the floor.
Obviously, they can't hold for the last shot.
So 10 seconds between the shot clock and the game clock. Anderson, 15 to work. He's going to isolate on Lewis. Anderson to the basket.
Tough
the floater
shot.
Is good.
Tough shot. 21 seconds left. Plenty of time.
Lewis Brooks for the lead.
In and out.
The offensive rebound is no good. The putback part of me is no good. Great offensive rebound by Mo Alley Cox. He'll go to the line.
Well, that shot was three quarters of the way down. And Mo Alley Cox, who's been virtually invisible all night, at the biggest possible moment, comes up with that rebound. Couldn't quite finish, but he'll go to the line to shoot two here.
He's one for two at the line tonight.
He's a good free throw shooter, though.
79% on the season.
And Jeff Neubauer is going to call time to do two things. One, he's going to let Mo Alley Cox think about the free throws. Two, he's going to tell his team what he wants them to do offensively if the game is tied. Because if the game isn't tied, if he misses one, obviously VCU is going to foul. But it'll be 1-1 at the free throw line because VCU's only committed 8 fouls. But the other thing is, if the score is tied, I don't think he wants to call timeout. He wants to get the ball in play and get it right down and try to get a shot in the open court.
Here's Fordham's upcoming schedule. They'll play Saturday at UMass. The home game against Davidson and Dayton.
There's absolutely no layups on that schedule. UMass is a solid team. We know about Davidson, Dayton. St. Joe's struggling a little bit, but down in Philly, always a tough game. And now Mo Alley Cox.
Senior at the line.
Guys like Mo Alley Cox, if I'm a coach, I want them on the line in this situation.
79% on the season. Conley knocks down the first one.
First one's usually the harder one. So I don't think Fordham will call timeout, but Will Wade might, because he still has one left. He's sending Johnny Williams to the scorer's table. He wants to stop the game that way.
Second free throw is good.
So now they get Johnny Williams in the game, and what that does is it allows Will Wade to set up his defense rather than use his last timeout. That's a very smart coaching move. You get a timeout in effect that way, and now they have to work against the setup pressure.
Here we go. All square, 58. 10 seconds. Anderson driving to the basket. Kicks it out. It's loose. Segfelder has it blocked. 2 seconds. Allie Cox playing it ahead to Brooks.
Overtime.
Can't get a hold of it. And we go to overtime.
This game had an overtime feel to it the last few minutes. Back and forth. As bad as it did back then, Georgia Tech has since beaten both North Carolina and NC State. At NC State.
How about the bench tonight for VCU? 29 points.
Ben saved it. That's the reason we're still playing.
Overtime underway. Williams spinning through traffic. Tillman from the baseline. Got it.
He can make it from out there. Boy, has he had a great second half. Got 15 points now.
Leading scorer for VCU. Averages just over 10 on the season. Here's Hawkins.
I believe that's VCU's first lead of the game.
Segfelder fakes the three. Hawkins looking to drive, has it poked away. What a play by Lewis. And it falls to Williams. Williams splitting traffic. His floater is good. Gets the roll.
If I'm Jeff Neubauer, and he got fouled. If I'm Jeff Neubauer, I call timeout right now. Because your team is sagging a little bit. They haven't been behind for 40 minutes. And now all of a sudden they're down four with Johnny Williams going to the line. Johnny Williams had a tough night going in the lane. But here, he gets that roll and the foul.
And that was all started by Lewis, who is third in the conference in steals per game. He just poked it away from Hawkins to lead that break the other way. Tillman knocks out the free throw.
I guess they called the foul after the basket, which is very unusual.
Second one, no good.
Ends up being a three-point play by two guys. That's very odd.
VCU on top, 63-58.
By the way, Justin Tillman in the first half, 0-for-4. Had a massive second half. That should have been up and down.
Hawkins draws contact, will go to the line.
Caught a break there.
And Tillman clearly likes playing against this Fordham team. He had a career-high 27 points last year in the 88-54 win. And he's come up big here again tonight.
That was almost an easy 27. And I don't mean that in a demeaning way. It was a blowout. His second half tonight has been huge because he's the major reason, along with the bench, that they've gotten this game into overtime.
Hawkins knocks down the free throw. Leading the score for Fordham tonight with 19 points as Burgess checks back in.
Will Wade has done a nice job using his bench tonight to spell his starters and to get production at the same time.
Hawkins connects on both. Three-point game. VCU never led in regulation. Hawkins all the way to the basket. High off the glass. Can't get it to go. Another quick first step. Just couldn't get it to finish. Hawkins up strong. Putback is in and out.
Wow, talk about not being able to finish. Owens had a wide open follow there.
I think Hawkins maybe was surprised by how quickly he got to the basket. They just put way too much up on that attempt. We approach 3 minutes to go in overtime. Not a good pass. It goes into the VCU fan section.
It's almost as if the VCU Rams, can't stand prosperity. They get a 5-point lead. Miss a shot in the lane, turn the ball over. Fordham has a chance to kind of catch their breath, get back in this game.
See, both teams, a high number of turnovers tonight. 21 for VCU, 20 for Fordham. Under three to go here in overtime.
I don't think the tape of this game is going to Springfield. Although in terms of intensity and how hard they played, it's been pretty darn good. And again, no help on defense there.
Chartuti wide open late in the basket.
Recognized that there was nobody back there.
Lewis in the corner. Brooks almost lost it.
Small lineup for VCU here. Tillman playing center.
15 on the shot clock.
Allie Cox at the scorer's table come in.
Brooks for three off balance. No good. And the rebounds to Fordham. They can take the lead.
Again, Rams after coming out with a burst to start the overtime. all of a sudden gone cold for him.
1 point game. Hawkins fakes the three, drives baseline, draws contact. He'll go to the line.
Fortunate to draw the foul there. I thought he should have taken the three. He was wide open. He's had a very solid game for Fordham. 18 points in regulation on 8 of 13 shooting. Sometimes scoring totals can be deceptive because guys are volume shooters. Hawkins has been very good tonight.
Knocks out the free throw. He's now been in double figures 8 straight games. Played 1 year in Eastern Kentucky. Was recruited by Jeff Neubauer there.
Jeff Neubauer recruited him as a transfer. He sat out a year. Then Neubauer left to come to Fordham. He said that the worst feeling he had leaving Eastern Kentucky, because he'd been there 10 years, was leaving Hawkins behind after he had recruited him as a transfer. Hawkins played as a senior last year, graduated, and was able to come here as a graduate student to finally get to play for Jeff Neubauer.
Hawkins makes both. Fordham back up by one.
Why hasn't the clock started? Clock didn't start for about 7 seconds there.
Lewis underneath to Tillman. Can't get it to go.
That was a good shot for Tillman. Just back-rimmed it. Fordham all of a sudden on a 6-0 run after VCU started the overtime on a 5-0 run.
Anderson with 10 on the shot clock. Under 2 to go.
They're dangerous when the shot clock gets down, aren't they?
Chartouni for 3. In and out. It was
my
all
goodness.
The way around and halfway down.
That's about
down.
The fourth time that's happened to each team.
Lewis driving strong. Leaves it for Tillman, and he throws it down for his 5th dunk of the game.
Well, that was a big moment in this game. Chartouni's 3 doesn't quite go down for a 4-point lead. And VCU takes the lead at the other end.
VCU up by 1 in overtime late in the Bronx.
Security and foreign policy objectives around the globe. We are honored to support the great men and women who serve our country.
VCU up by 1 in overtime. And John, in large part, thanks to Dustin Tillman, who has a team high 18 points tonight.
Yeah, he's had a huge second half in overtime. Very good pass by Jaquan Lewis there, recognizing that he was behind the defense. And as I said, if VCU goes on to win, that sequence may be what Will Wade looks back on. Chartouni's 3 being all the way down and out, and then VCU being able to come back and take the lead on that dunk and off the nice pass by Lewis.
I still can't believe Chartouni's 3 didn't go down.
It almost hit the floor.
All the way
so far down.
Here is Anderson. And
you
a
got
bump.
Push. You got to call that. And that is the 10th foul, so they'll shoot. He'll shoot 2.
That'll put Antoine Anderson to the line.
Kind of a mental mistake by Doug Brooks there.
Anderson, a 75% free throw shooter. And his first attempt of the night, he's off the mark.
Helps Fordham that he was in a two-shot double bonus there. But once you miss the first, that second one gets a little bit tighter. But like I said.
Nothing but net.
Nothing but net. So a tie ball game again.
65-65. 1 minute to play in overtime. VCU trying to make it 7 straight against Fordham. Williams. Underneath the basket, goes down.
That's Fordham's ball if it's a tie-up.
And Tillman was the intended target that time.
Yeah, he wanted to get it to Tillman, but Fordham anticipated that he wanted to get it to Tillman because that's what VCU's been doing this entire second half, is trying to get penetration, draw the defense to the guard, and then find Tillman. That time they stayed with Tillman and were able to get the tie-up and the basketball.
A chance here for Fordham.
Again, clock not really a factor because there's such a big difference. 43 seconds in the game, 24 on the shot clock. So the best thing Fordham can do is just try to get the best shot they possibly can.
Anderson looking to work on Brooks. All the way to the basket.
That's
the first layup
shot.
Is good. What a burst by Anderson.
Again, that lack of help defense for VCU.
Brooks for the lead. That's short. Missed everything. And then a foul.
And Omens comes up with that rebound. Brooks was well defended that time. They got to him. They got to the shooter. Open shots most of this second half from three-point range. That was not an open shot. That's why it was an air ball.
I understand Brooks is hot here in the second half, but they rushed out. Here's the move by Anderson to the basket. What a great first step.
Yeah, he just simply beat Brooks and then makes that reverse layup. And then defensively, excellent play by Fordham to get to the guy who's been VCU's best three-point shooter. Made sense to look for him. And now Mo Alie-Cox, I believe, is fouled out.
He will take a seat.
Now, Ohams, I'm just guessing as a freshman, he hasn't been to the line much, but he does have two.
That's a good guess. He's 0 for 3 on the season.
There you go. So, good guy to foul if you're going to foul somebody, and that's not close. So now, this one's important because if he makes this one, VCU doesn't have to shoot a three with 23 seconds left, but they might want to think about it. If he misses, you just take the best shot. And that's not going in either. He's 0 for 5 on the year. Another chance for the Ram.
Down two. Lewis to the basket. Leaves it for Tillman.
Bobbled it.
Got it back. Score the basket and a foul. Tillman has been a beast in the second half.
Wow. That was a beastly play because he dropped the ball on the initial pass and was able to recover and go up between two Florida players and finish. Remember what I said early in the game? He goes up. Owens commits the foul. And he's able to finish after bobbling the ball between two Fordham players.
He's in double figures in four straight games coming into tonight. His season high on the year is 26 in that overtime loss to Georgia Tech.
Well, these 20 have been absolutely critical.
And he's coming off 11.9 rebound game against Davidson. One rebound shy of his third double-double on the year.
And Jeff Neubauer calls timeout here. He's got one left, but he uses his full timeout here because, again, he wants to talk. First of all, he wants to have Tillman think about the free throw with the score tied. But he also wants to tell his players what he wants offensively with 14.7 seconds. Because the last time in this circumstance with the score tied, well, they got a blocked shot. And they need to do better than that on this next possession, whether they're down one or tied. I think you run the same thing regardless of score here. You just try to get down and get the best shot you can as quickly as you can, even if the score is tied, because by the time you get into your offense, the clock's going to be down anyway, and if you miss, you want to have a chance at a rebound.
The last couple of dives down the court, see Fordham has successfully been able to get to the baseline.
They did. And again, Mo Alie-Cox is out of the game now. And although Brooks has been, Tillman has been a monster at both ends of the court. If I am Jeff Neubauer, first I want to get this rebound if the shot is missed. But second, regardless, I think I want Hawkins with the ball. He's their best player, and he's been their best player tonight. One way or the other, I want him touching the ball.
Game high 22 points. Tillman is 2 for 3 at the line tonight.
20 points all in the second half and overtime.
He's just a 60% free throw shooter on the season.
He has that unusual way, just steps in and shoots. Swish. Nope. Somebody stepped to the lane, I think. What are we calling? No, it's not two shots. Wally Rutecki made a mistake. Wally Rutecki thought it was a two-shot foul. He forgot that the basket had been made, and he was trying to complete the three-point play. He was looking at the 10 fouls. So, tie ball game, and Fordham taking a lot of time here to get it up court.
Anderson. Five on the shot clock.
Here comes Hawkins behind him.
Anderson's got to go. Anderson for the win.
Got it! Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Anderson did everything